Your boy is right.
Welcome to Celtics Post Game Live. Eddie House, Amina Smith here with you. The Celtics win this one against the Brooklyn Nets 121-107. Their first in-season tournament game. Also a bounce back game for this Celtics team that was on a two-game losing skid. Eddie, what was the big story to come out of this matchup for you?
Well, get back on the right track. And I think that they played offense the right way, but they also got after defensively. I know Brooklyn is an undersized team, but you did exactly what you were supposed to do against an undersized team. You punish them, you attack the paint, and you collapse the defense, and you get easy looks at the basket.
And what did it look like the Celtics really worked on coming back into this game that they lost maybe or maybe lost track of in that game on Wednesday against the Sixers?
I think it was the ball movement offensively, number one. Body and ball movement offensively, and then defensively getting back to the basics. You know, they limited them to one shot. They wasn't allowing multiple opportunities. You know, they made sure that they closed out the possession with the rebound. And I just like the energy that they had. And oh, I would like to see Jrue Holiday was, I think, one assist shy.
Short of a triple-double.
Yeah, of a triple-double. And when he came out, I think Joe was like, Joe did his head like that. I don't think Joe understood that part.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
You're just coaching the game and things like that. So at the end of the day, I think everybody got back on track like they needed to and a good win.
Well, one person who was back on track was Jaylen Brown. He had a lot of points. 28 points in this game. Started with 12 points in that first quarter. Abby Chin is with him after this win.
Jaylen, you guys were looking for a bounce back, but you came out hot, scoring 6 of the first 10 points. Really never cooled off. What was your mindset coming in?
Just being aggressive. You know, it's a long season. Just coming out, just playing my game and looking for my teammates and just trying to find ways to win.
These Nets put you guys in some uncomfortable positions, especially in transition. How do you like the defense tonight?
They're a pretty good team. They make you play a different way, and they got some talent over there. So give credit to them. They came out and played hard, but we was able to get a win.
The guys off the bench have had a little trouble getting started this season. How nice was it to see guys like Peyton and Sam and Luke come through?
Yeah, that's what we're going to need. We're going to need those guys over the duration of the year, so keep those guys confident. It's good to see some of those shots go down for those guys, and we just got to keep it going.
And this was it, the first in-season tournament game ever for the Boston Celtics. You told me the other day you were ready. What'd you think?
So far, so good. I think the court looked pretty cool. It wasn't too slippery or anything, so I had fun. So looking for the next one.
It looked like it. Jaylen, thank you.
Thank you.
Scal joining us live courtside. And Scal, you just heard Jaylen Brown. He had a bounce back game tonight. Started off hot with 12 points in that first quarter. What was JB able to do best in this matchup?
He had a lot of space to work. He took care of the basketball. Celtics only had 7 turnovers as a group. I thought he made some threes early, and I thought he carried that confidence throughout. But the way the Celtics played today, moving the ball, 29 assists, 7 turnovers, I feel like anybody could have been that guy. Today happened to be Jaylen Brown.
How important is it, Eddie, for Jaylen Brown to set that spark? We've seen it time and time again where that is where he gets hot, and that's something that he's used to. How important is it for him to set the tone?
Well, I think it's super important because a lot of times guys are just kind of fill out the first few minutes of the game. But if you come in downhill playing with a lot of force and playing with intensity that he usually starts games with, when he has big games like this, that's how he starts it off. I think it sets a tone, not only for himself, but it sets a tone for the team.
Scal, when you talk about Jaylen Brown and what he's able to do in this matchup, how did he not let last game affect what he did tonight against the Nets?
I just think he felt like he had more space to work. Like, if you looked at the Celtics offense, remember, there's no Joel Embiid in there. There's no Rudy Gobert in the Minnesota game. So with that, with those guys at the rim, like Jaylen Brown and Jason Tatum, if they want to turn the corner, they're going to be able to do that. The guys for Brooklyn, they know they don't have that last line of defense, so they can't get into your airspace. So when you look at all that, you give those guys some comfort, you give them some space, and they're going to go to work. And I think Jaylen Brown, right from the start, he was going to have a different mindset this game.
Yeah, and also I think on top of what Scal is saying with the space, the space was created with other guys penetrating and collapsing the defense. I think that's the big part of the Celtics' success. If you continue to attack the paint, get into the paint, collapse the defense, you have opportunities to get a lot of space, a lot of one-on-one opportunities, and I'll take our chances with our guys versus other guys with a lot of space and it being a one-on-one opportunity.
Time now for the Four Tough play of the game, presented by Ford Trucks, built for tough. Chris Stapps, Porzingis going up. He says, nah, not on my watch. Goes up and gets the block right here. He said, let me get that. Third quarter play for Chris Stapps, Porzingis. Also a plus 20 on the floor tonight. Eddie House, Amina Smith back here with you. Let's talk a little bit about Jrue Holiday's night. 13 points, 12 rebounds, and 9 assists. And just like you mentioned, Eddie, at the top of the show, just one assist shy of a triple-double. Pretty much the same story as the last time the Celtics face the Brooklyn Nets. Why does Jrue Holiday match up so well with this team?
I'm going to tell you in 1 second, because I haven't been able to get this off. I want to wish Raquel a happy birthday.
Happy birthday!
The love of my life, my best friend, happy birthday, and I hope she's having a great time right now. But the reason why Jrue Holiday is so special is because he's so versatile on the defensive side. He could guard multiple defenders, number one. But then on the offensive side, what he brings to the table, he's a three-level scorer. He could score at all three levels, and he could take over games. He's had a 50-point game before. He sets guys up. He could set the table. He wants to set the table. He takes whatever the defense gives him. And he was one assist shy of that triple-double. But again, double-figure rebounds. When you're getting double-figure rebounds from your guard position, that is always a plus. And to me, he just understands how to win. He understands how to play the game. He doesn't try to force anything. And that's the reason why night in, I think, early on, because he's still trying to get his footing with this team.
Right.
As this year goes on, we're going to see we're going to see better and better games from Jrue Holiday on both sides of the ball. And, I mean, this is just the tip of the iceberg.
As a floor general, how does Jrue Holiday help elevate the play of other guys out there on the court?
It's basketball IQ.
Yeah.
You know, when you understand the game and you understand how to get your shot, or you understand where to get somebody else their shots and when to go, when not to go, when to slow it down, when to defer to somebody or when to be aggressive, he understands all that. I mean, he's been in every situation you can think of. He's a gold medal, world champion. He won a gold medal. He's a world champion. So he's been in all the brightest of the lights. So none of these lights or none of these situations are going to be anything that's new to him. Mm-hmm. Played at UCLA. So, I mean, come on. You already know the tradition and the history that place has. So when I look at it, he's just going to get better and better and better as he gets more and more comfortable with this team.
The Celtics also had that ball hopping around out there. 29 assists for the Celtics in this win against the Brooklyn Nets. What role did that play in this matchup?
That's this team, number one. That's this team. I don't care what anybody wants to say. We do have great individual offensive players that could go get it at any time, that will have a mismatch any time. But when you attack the rim, when you get paint touches, because you have the ability to get by your guy, you can make an easy shot, be a great shot for somebody else. So if I pass it to you, you have a good look, but then you kick it to somebody else who has a great look. That's when you get those 29 assists on 41 field goals. To me, that's when the Celtics are playing their best basketball.
Oh, yeah.
Is when they're sharing it, they're getting everybody involved. And then at the end, big-time guys going to take over. We got JT that could take over. And then any one of those guys, any one of our starting five, our six players can take over a game. But it starts with sharing the basketball. But number one, before that, it also starts with playing defense.
Right. And then also, how does the assist speak to the selflessness of this team as well that they've been preaching throughout the beginning of this season?
Well, I think the understanding of that this is how we're going to have to play to be successful. I think the last couple games, you know, we kind of got stuck in the mud a little bit offensively to where we were, you know, it was one guy trying to get through a wall of defenders. And, well, when you move that ball and you attack, now the defense is collapsing, the defense is shrunk, and then now you could kick it out, guys could get wide open shots, and when they close out, you could attack that close out and do it all over again and get a great look. So I think the more they play together, they'll start understanding it, and they'll start getting that identity. Right now it's early in the season, so you just want to continue to build. If I'm Joe Mazzulla, I take clips of what we do right when we've been winning, and I take clips of what we have been doing wrong when we've been losing, and show, like, hey, this is our recipe for success.